contribution comes asynchronously. That means something Turing machine concept comes 1936 and 37 in Alan Turing's paper, and 1951 that gentleman Stephen Cole Kleene fully give the expression of regular expression, and that is has to be expected another 2-3 years. So you think that regular expression is such an obvious thing, but it is formalized by Stephen Cole Kleene, that is called the Kleene's closure, in 1951, and your Turing machine came 1936, which is much advanced. That is, we are still not. We are just giving references, and in push-down automata come later. Everything in computer science happens after Turing's 1936-37 paper. So that is very young science, and all big scientists, all big so-called computer scientists, have contributed in this automata and formal language. Then another giant, Alan Turing, is from the machine side, and Noam Chomsky single-handedly developed the type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 language. Nobody before it. So he is still alive, 93-year-old. He's basically a linguist. So computer science is a potpourri of mathematics and linguist, physicist. Most of the early computer science are from mathematics and physics. Then comes even linguist, like read their good books. There is MIT videos are also very good. You can see their videos, their notes. I have copied MIT notes. I have mentioned it. I mostly followed Michael Sipse's book. Just within an hour, so what is basically Kleene's theorem? Kleene's have many theorems. So, but what is Kleene's theorem for regular expression? That say a language L is accepted by a finite state machine if and only if L is regular. Very obvious, you think, but this obvious thing is not obvious in 1950s. So right now obvious, but one thing, proof is not within your syllabus. You try to understand proof for your own sake, for intelligence, but it will be definitely if you go for PhD and MTech, you are asked to give proof. A language is L accepted by a finite if and only really regular. That's, I think, we have all understood. Let's see, regular expression, these I have covered. So let's, yeah, I think this expression, this slide, I'll repeat lectures, some lectures. This is very obvious, but you try to understand. This is epsilon, okay, and this is a shy language. So this is the initial state and this is the final state. No epsilon is there, so your language will be a big shy, that means a blank language. But remember, this language is epsilon. So this is the shy and this is the epsilon. Completely two different language. Here, in this here, in the A diagram, anything is accepted. So anything, any damn thing is accepted. So even say epsilon concept is nothing is there, but it is there. And here nothing is there, nothing is there. So here is your language is epsilon, and here is the language is shy. Two different things. And this is interesting. This particular machines, first of all, it is not a infinite language, it's a finite language. Why? Because only one transition you go to final state. If there are further A comes, there is no state given, so it would not be accepted. So this language is a finite language, band length is 1 and only A is accepted. So but you detect it by a flip-flop circuit, that's it. How to get a complex finite state machine, how to get a complete finite state machine from a regular expression? It is better to design block by block DFA. Then all DFA you can have a new start state, and with epsilon there, and new start state, new final state. That you, in epsilon NFA, you have that liberty. You have only one start state, final state maybe more than one, but here is simplification. So this is a DFA, this is a DFA, but the whole picture is not DFA, NFA with epsilon, and this is R plus S, either R or S. So in set theory it will be R union S, and regular expression will be R plus S. Regular expression is R plus S. This is RS. I think this I have covered again and again. This is RS with epsilon. So this is a DFA. This is a DFA. But whole this is NFA because epsilon is there. So it is sometimes you need both ways. Not only regular expressions to NFA or epsilon NFA and DFA. Sometimes you have to design from DFA, NFA, epsilon NFA to regular expressions. So you have to, the all kinds of questions will be there in exam and everywhere. So this is, I already covered, this is a, you can say this is a clean closure. So this is a DFA and this is R star. So remember, if we epsilon, no, this is okay. This is one interesting diagram. This is, please remember, this is NFA. Why NFA? Why NFA? Because with 1 you can go to A and with 1 you can go B. So that is NFA, definitely NFA, but it is not with epsilon NFA. So there is no such epsilon transition. So this is NFA because with 1. So always whenever you are given an example, you are given a NFA, you have to get it regular expression. See differently. Not regular expression to NFA. So you are given a NFA and you have to get regular expression. Reverse. And regular expression is not unique. Regular expression can be like DFA is be always unique. Regular expression might not be unique. Okay, that is, so that is another challenge. So here, whenever you see 0, 1, always replace all symbols and arcs with regular expression with 0, 1. So I think you have understood, this is either 0 or 1. So you must replace next diagram 0, 1. Here 1, here say 0, 1, you replace 0, 1. Here also 0, 1. Okay, I think you have understood. This is it. Here from the same, see here. So that is the thing. We have combined this. I am going back to previous again slot. See here. What we have done, from this diagram to this diagram, we go for 0, 1. Now, this is basically a concatenation. So, I should concatenate 1 with 0, 1. So, I should then eliminate B. So, when I go A to C by 1 with first bracket 0, 1, 1 concatenate, 1 concatenate 0, 1, we can go to A to C. Then there will be no B. So this is a simplified next stage. This diagram, please mind it, this will eliminate B and this arc will be 1 concatenate with 0, 1 within bracket. Always whenever you have confusion, use in parenthesis. So that we have done, we have eliminated B. So remember from the first diagram we have done this, we have eliminated B with this regular. This is also a finite state, final state, an accepted state. And this is also accepted state. So why both are required? We can simplify it, think of it. So first thing, what I have done, 0, 1, we done it by regular expression. This is regular expression. Then we say second state B, 1 with B, then 0, 1, C. So we concatenate. So we eliminate B. Now we see C is also final state. And another 0, 1 operation also a final state. So what I could do, we can eliminate D at all. We can eliminate D. So we can make it. So final regular expression will be like this. Like this. Say here 0, 1 star with 1, 0, 1. And this is the two way you can make it. One is versus C. One is D. This is one of the my favorite diagram. I will explain the diagram not bottom up, from top down approach. Okay, from top down. How much we have finished in our course? Probably we have done covered this regular languages. So this is regular language. Regular language is example by regular set equivalent. There is another concept that is called transition graph. That can be also same equivalent. It can be shown. Regular expressions is same. Finite state machine is same. NFA, if you convert it to DFA, same. Epsilon NFA. So all are same. All are same. And this is a regular languages. So what is automata? Automata is a machine. And language, what is language? The language is finite language. We are not bothered, because I have told finite language is always done by a combinatorial circuit. We are interested in infinite language. Infinite language means like you go to a college street, you buy a new storybook, or through Amazon you buy a English language book or something. So all books are different, but they all basically come from sigma star, where sigma is A to Z. But the interesting story, interesting essays is coming. Basically there are some rules definitely in English grammar. By maintaining the rules, and then the, that is a syntactic rule, and then also semantic rule. Like a mosquito eats an elephant, doesn't mean. Even elephant eats a mosquito, doesn't mean. When elephant is herbivore, so we know. So there should be some meanings is there. The both are syntactically correct, but there is no meaning. The meaning check is done by semantic check. That is another part of linguistics. First is syntax. Syntax is, what is syntax checking? We have to check whether in English language noun clause comes first, verb clause second, like this. This kind of syntax check is done by push-down automata. I have explained. So that is it. So coming back to the regular language is excellent for detecting variable declaration in your programming language or integer variable declaration, because you know the variables to start with alpha, some alphabets, and then any numbers or alphabets, but not semicolon under hyphen, not underscore is there, not semicolon should be accepted. So that is nothing but you can check it by a regular expression. So there will be different regular expressions, so that is great. But what is the problem of regular language is there is no other computation device to match the a to the power m, b to the power m, like when m and m's are similar. A to the power, I mean again, a to the power n for Nagaland, b to the power n. So both n are same, or a to the power n, b to the power 2n, because here 2n should be 2 times n. When there is some comparison comes, you need a stack. You need with finance FSM, but stack. But remember, finance FSM is there. So then the problem is what is the sort of advantage? Whenever you have this kind of language, like that deterministic context-free grammar, there is a generally context-free grammar. Left-hand side solely production rules. Left-hand side saying a single variable. But there are the two type of deterministic context-free grammar. That is a to the power n, b to the power n, and parenthesis languages. And next is palindrome languages. That is difficult. And we programming languages do not try to that, because to absorb, to understand this language, the palindrome language, you need a non-deterministic PDA. And non-deterministic PDA is totally unlike non-deterministic FSM. Non-deterministic FSM has the same power. What is meant by power? Power means it can understand the same language, but you can say non-deterministic FSM had fewer state, she should do it quickly. But no, at the non-deterministic FSM is good to capture image on your paper, but to design it in hardware is very, very difficult. So it is not done. Everything is converted to FSM, and that's it. So, but unfortunately, non-deterministic push-down automata cannot be realizable by hardware. Limited hardware. So, and there your then the compilation is, it is proven, it is a your, if your number of terminals is the sentence comes is n, it could be n cube this polynomial. But this, that means your programming languages, it takes compilation. See, if you have a 10 lines program, it takes 10 seconds. That's too much. Say 2 seconds. 100 lines programs will take cubing times. So it is absurd. It's absolutely nonsense. So then we have to have devise such a grammar within a context-free grammar. We have to devise such a grammar which is unambiguous. Unambiguous means this parsing tree is unique, and your compilation will be like linear. It should be linear. So that's a challenge. So it will be n cube, but we try to make it n for the grammar like a to the power n, b to the power n, or parenthesis, and we'll prove that we can make a unambiguous. We can have unambiguous grammar, because see, language and grammar is not 1:1. One language have many grammars. Okay. Many grammars can generate one language, and in context-free language, it is unsolvable problem. I have told you to show the grammars are equivalent. So only way you can show that they are generating the same language or not, and even if say one language can be generated by 10 grammar, that example I am giving again and again you, if 9 of them give ambiguous grammar, that means you can come to a string by different rules by same string, but if one of them you can find it is unambiguous, so we can say language is unambiguous to that grammar. So we always try to find that grammar which is unambiguous, and finding unambiguous grammar, it is a ad hoc, it is not child's play. So there is no some algorithm, so you have to just try and see it whether it is unambiguous or not. So I can say language will leave unambiguous whenever this grammar is unambiguous. So language to grammar relation is one to many, not many to many, one to many true. It should be one language, it can have several grammars, and we should see that if it is a deterministic context free grammar, it is a unambiguous grammar, we can find it, then it should be linear. We will prove it will be linear like regular language. That is great. That is the thing, your compilation will take number of lines of your code, not cubing times. Okay, and then we'll go context sensitive grammar, that is exponential, so we'll not try. So my Hill Neurath theorem exactly not saying theorem says that you have equivalence classes should be limited. So it may be AB in regular expression, it can be AB plus A square B square plus A cube B cube plus if here plus means union, okay, like union. So it can be AB, but if we go for A, B, N is any number, then mean you have infinite equivalence classes, so that must not be regular. That is the Myhill-Neurath theorem says. Now your question is, whenever you are giving a DFA and minimization of DFA, your question is basically minimization of DFA. So first step is minimization of DFA. You have to have only one initial state, and you can have one acceptance or more than one, or all state can be accepted. Okay, so take the example that you said should be always one, so initial and non-final state together. Okay, so this is the final, and another is all final states. So your first divide and rule should be left hand side. Right hand side should be all final states, and left hand side should be all state minus final states. Agreed? There would be initial state would be there. So that is not the, and right hand side should be all final state. Now you go state by state on the every left half. So whether in the next state you are jumping to final state group or other group. If you see your groups with change, and say you divide your group again, so that is every transition we divide, and then at the end of the thing you see you cannot have, say if you have a 16 state, if you have a 16 groups, that you know you cannot minimize it, but it can happen. You have a 16 state or 10 state, it can have come 5 groups, and any other changes you they are coming into the same group. So then you definitely say these group can be combined. So every 5 what are these can be combined.